sharp, but Oregon's a really good team offensively. I mean, they were hitting huge numbers against us till the end there, and really impressed with the Oregon's team and their offense. I mean, you know, when you don't have a chance to prepare for it, it is very difficult to prepare or to just jump in a match and play against. But I thought our team made some adjustments. We started stressing them with our serve, and you know, found a way to win some close games and some big points. And the other thing I just have to say is that you know, Michaela and Kenzie continue to raise a very high bar at Nebraska, four straight Final Fours now, and it's just hard to put that into words with, you know, how hard. Trying to jam up the stone and their middles and at Willow. We were just trying to serve in there. We were trying to create some problems for them so they couldn't get their big approaches. And so really serving helped set that up. And then we got, I think we only had two blocks. So we got three blocks in that game. And those were some big blocks. We got touches. We got some digs. We got some easy tips out of it. So we just were able to just disrupt their rhythm because they were humming.
You guys won two close sets to start the match. Why did you win close sets now when you didn't earlier in the year?
Yeah, our team has worked so hard, and every single day we come into practice with the intention and we focus, and I think that's what separates us, because some teams just go through the motions when they get into the gym, but us, we really try to get better every single day. We never take a play off, never take a day off.
John, yesterday you said that you feel like you're the most improved team in the country. What was kind of a turning point or things that led up to being the most improved team, you feel like?
Our turning point was beating Penn State. That was our turning point. That's when we realized, okay, we'd beaten Illinois earlier, but then we went through a really tough stretch, and then we finally got Penn State, which I think was our sixth top 10 team we played almost in a row. And winning that, I could just see our team from there and get confidence. Put in perspective, career right now, I think it's 51-2. So maybe we've been a really improved team every year. So, but give these guys deserve the credit, the leadership that they bring every day, and how they work, and it's really impressive.
Okay, what makes you most proud of what you guys did?
I think just where we started the season, having such a young team and so many new players, it can be hard to establish a culture. And I think that we've worked really hard together to get the culture that we want. And we've been working on our bonds with each other, both on and off the court. And I think that that's just really been showing now on the court. And obviously that's what we want to see. And so I think that just seeing that and seeing everyone play so hard for each other tonight was really rewarding.
New players, how hard was it?
I think one of the things that our team prides ourselves on is going point by point, and so no matter what happened the play before, we're going to shake it off, and we're just going to focus on that next point. And I think a great example of that is when Lexi hit that overpass under the net, and then the next play she turned it around and stuff blocked Willow. So I think that's just like goes to show like our kind of mindset towards every single game. Just shake off the point before and focus on the next one.
Coach, you've seen Oregon in the past few years in the breakout. How have you seen them grow, especially in the last couple of years as Coach Olmert's head coaching job? How have you seen them grow and change?
Well, I remember in 2015, the first time we played them, I think we beat them in five. Close match, and those seniors were freshmen. And I remember telling my assistants at the time, look out for Oregon, because they've got some really good players. Those guys are really know how hard that is. I mean, it is monumental to be able to do that, what they did last night, how they did it. So I have a lot of respect and give them a lot of credit for the job that was done building that team to get to that point. Like I said, this was a really tough match. They made us feel very uncomfortable today. We had one edge to that.
Lauren, what would we have seen and heard if we were in the locker room 10 minutes ago?
Yeah, just a lot of smiles, a lot of jokes, and a lot of hugs. And I'm not usually a person that likes hugs, but man, we were happy. Everyone was getting hugs. Yeah.
Okay, well, when you've got so many good players, how do you go about building that culture and build that camaraderie?
I think it starts with the older upperclassmen, the people that have been here before, and know what we want the culture to be. And first off, you have to exemplify it. And if you don't, how can you expect them to follow you? And so I think that's what we worked really hard on in the spring was, you know, defining our culture and then working to exemplify it every single day. And then I think just laying out the guidelines for the newcomers as to what our culture is, what we expect every single day, and then just going out and doing it.
An obvious question was, when you explain what that culture is, what do you tell these players?
I mean, for us, like, we only have a few general rules, and it's like you always have to be on time, you go after every ball, and you talk on every touch. And I mean, that seems pretty plain and simple, but there's a lot of teams that don't do that. And so I think that that's just like a general baseline for us and things that we want to do every single time. And so that starts with like me and Lauren and Kenzie and Brooke and people that have been through it before.
Coach, how important was it for Megan and Capri to come in and contribute and change this match?
Huge. And that's, talked to the team about the job that Megan did. Megan had a couple big runs serving. She was serving really tough. And then Capri got us, you know, a couple big kills when we needed it. So, you know, for freshmen to step up and play like that is really big.
Lauren, to get that tip on to end the second set, if you guys had rallied from 5 or 7 points, what was it feeling to win that second set like that?
Yeah, it's a great feeling. I mean, I don't know. I just know that even if that ball didn't go down, that we were going to get that next point or even finish out that one. Our team just worked so hard, and I don't know. I just didn't see that game going in their favor at all. I just knew and trusted in my teammates and our coaches, and we finished out that set strong.
John, what did it mean to you to play in front of so many Nebraska fans 6 hours away from home?
I was wondering today what the crowd would be like, but I got a lot of texts and emails from people saying, hey, we're coming up. And so I had a feeling there would be a large contingency. What they say, 4,800. There's no place like Nebraska.
Lauren, what was it like when you guys got the block going at the end of the second set? Why were you able to get the block going? What did that do for
that? Yeah, I think we just took a deep breath and we were talking before every play, and Jalen had done a great job scouting out the team and just telling us what to expect. So I think it starts with our communication and then our execution. We work on blocking more than any other drill in the gym, so it's nice to see it finally pay off.
We have any more for Nebraska?
John, when you walked out of here last night, it sounded like you technically asked about the draw on how the four out of five big 10 teams are on the same side. Now that you're going to face one at the national semifinals, is there something inherently wrong with that? Is there something that bothers you about it?
When you have a conference that has five of the top teams, four of the Elite Eight, and six in the Sweet 16, and, you know, they're knocking each other off, it's tough. I mean, Wisconsin played Illinois today, and there's a good chance we're going to play Minnesota today. I don't know. You know, the committee has to live with what they do, and they go about their business. But I'm not. I have a feeling this was men's basketball. There would be sports talk would be going all day long, discussing all this, and I think you'd see some coaches stepping up. Like, you know, you have five ACC teams all knocking each other off. So, but it's a credit to our conference. This conference.